we went into a popular Asian TV station yesterday to record an interview. And the owner of the station turned around and asked us, yeah, how's work going? And we were like, yeah, busy, 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 you know, whatever. And, you know, and he was like, okay, you know, is this all you do? And we were like, yeah, you know, we're musicians, this is all we do. And he turned around and he goes, why don't you get a proper job?
You know, like, serious.
People still don't regard, like, you know, people who want to, you know, follow a career in music as being people that actually have a career. You know, they don't consider music a career.
I'm still taken aback by that comment. Well, how did you respond to that? What did you say?
Yeah, there is no
response.
There's no need to give a response to something like that. Something as stupid as that just doesn't deserve a response. You know,
okay, so that was the first line that he came out with, and the next line was, how about you do a show for us? So it's like, on one level,
he's insulted you.
Yeah, and then the next level is like, okay, come and do a show for us. But it's like, yeah, do a show for us to promote yourself. You're not actually going to get anything out of it apart from promotion. You know what I mean? And these kind of things just show that, really, you know, this, to a lot of people, this thing, this music thing, or, you know, this,
they treat it as a commodity, and they treat it
as a little
money making scam type thing. You know,
they don't treat it as, in the wrong way. You know,
yeah. I mean, people just don't have the respect for music in the way that they should, and I think that's a lot to do with the fact that the industry isn't made up of musicians. It's made up of wannabe DJs.
Do you think that's partly to blame with the technologies of, like, torrenting, downloading, all that kind of thing? Because, like, before, you know, we used to go out to the record store a couple of years back, you know, buy the latest Method Man album or buy the latest, you know, whatever. And now it's like, yeah, I'll just torrent it, you know, I'll just download it and stuff, you know. And is that starting to kill off?
See, I don't know.
Downloading music is not...
It's not the problem. It's not the problem, because, to be honest, okay, a lot of people might not be paying for the music, but a lot of people are consuming that music, and consumption leads to demand. You know, the fact that there's so many people consuming music across the world that maybe wouldn't be able to consume that music means that there's demand created in those regions for live shows. You know,
but, you know, bands are tuning off the fact that, you know, they're just big on MySpace. You know, and people, you know, people,
MySpace
just,
bands, yeah,
you know, people just heard their stuff, or people download their tunes. Even some bands are just putting the whole album up for free download. You know, and it's not a problem. You know what I mean? It could be that, you know, the next Tiger Style album is a free album. It could happen. But, you know, the setup needs to be correct, that, you know, okay, once the album's out there, then what's the next stage? And how is an artist going to survive? You know, and how are we going to pay the bills? And how are we going to go out there and connect with the people that have consumed our music to be able to give them an experience that, you know, we can gain from?
I mean, there's a lot that people can get, that can gain from just looking at the credit crisis type thing.
Yeah.
You know, when the money runs out, things get, you know, problems occur.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's the same thing with any industry. When the revenue runs out within that industry, that industry flops. And that's what could eventually happen to Bhangra. Like, at the end of the day, if people just download things willy-nilly and just don't bother paying for anything, then, you know, labels are going to face problems, and artists will then have to look at a different form of distribution and find a different way to reach the public, and still be able to be artists that survive on the basis of their talent. Record labels are the people that really face the problem, and they're the people that actually take a lot of risk, you know, and investing in artists and being willing to invest in videos and promotion and so on, and they put a lot of money behind these things. And you know, Bhangra fans are really contradictory, you know. Like, on one side, they'll complain that, you know, artists don't come out with big albums anymore. You don't see albums that have a lot of well-known singers, or you don't see albums that have 4 or 5 videos, you know, that are all of a high standard or whatever. But those same fans will be people that go online and download everything.
Quick example that I think, I don't think anyone's going to mind if I mention it, is Jazzy B's album this year. It's probably been one of the biggest Bhangra albums, you know, of recent times.
Yeah.
Rambo's been a very hyped up album, you know.
It's had its fair share of scrutiny at the same time.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I mean, you know, the company or the artist was coming out like, yeah, you know, this is the biggest, the most expensive Bhangra video ever made, you know. And it, to look at it was, you know, there was cars in there that you never even seen before. You know, you had a plane in there, you know, and just, you know, it's a crisp video. And still people complain.
Yeah.
You know? I mean, and he's topping what the hip hop artists are doing. Yeah. And still people complain.
Yeah. And plus the thing is, like, it's like people always look at the negative thing, you know, and are quick to point the finger and say that, yeah, they spent this much on a video, but it still looks like crap, you know, or, you know, they might act like they're bad artists and that, but, you know, we chucked a bottle at him in a club or something like that, you know, they're not going to think about the fact that, you know what, this guy's actually trying to raise his game, you know, this guy's trying to make videos on a big level and has spent a budget,
in a climate where music isn't actually making any money. He's spending money, you know, and that's a big thing.
Yeah, and plus the thing is, like, you know, if those same Bhangra fans, instead of, you know, downloading the artist's album and then having the nerve to actually go on message boards and cuss that person when you haven't even bought the album, fair enough, if you've bought the album, you have the right to an opinion then, you know, because you spent your money on it. If you didn't buy the album, then what gives you the right to actually sit there and say that, you know, that artist's album was rubbish? Because you haven't given that artist any worth in the first place.
Yeah.
You know? It's kind of a vicious circle. You know, Bhangra fans don't do justice to themselves. It's weird.
So really quickly, I mean, what advice would you give to someone that's thinking about becoming a producer or like a bedroom producer? You know, that's just out there.
Well, learn. That's all I'm going to say is just learn.
Learn.
Because to be honest, like, put it this way, if someone really wanted to become a brilliant singer, then the best thing that they could do is to actually take an ustad and learn from that ustad and learn rag vidya, and so that they know what surgyan is and what dal is, and, you know about how to utilize rag and how to come up with the composition, you know, and really convey the emotion from a song.
And the language as well, you know, whether you're singing, I mean, if you're singing in English, then you would know how to write English, or you would know how to read it in English. And I think the same thing needs to apply when, you know, when you're singing in Punjabi or any other language, you should be able to read and write it. And if you don't, then you're not doing justice to that language.